السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most kind. Thank you so much for tuning in again in Out of Focus, our new program aimed at youth and the teenagers today in our generation. Today, again, we have our two guests joining us, Nabila and Shamila.
My name's Shamila.
They swap seats. Yeah.
So
today our topic's name is social media interaction, and this is a very controversial topic where we are going to be discussing different Islamic things to do with social media interaction. And social media is basically like everything everyone associates with social media, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's technology, because technology is increasing day by day. Social media is increasing, isn't it?
Yeah.
And the interaction between people,
yeah,
literally in other parts of the world, is increasing.
Yeah, like a lot of children, not even children, like teenagers, everyone these days are starting to use, like, are getting more into like social media, and they're starting to have like Facebook,
WhatsApp,
Vine, WhatsApp,
Twitter, BBM,
yeah,
Instagram,
and so many,
Snapchat. There's so many things.
And I'm pretty sure like us three, like we're using that.
We're using it as well. Everyone uses it,
yeah,
isn't
everyone
it?
Uses it, but
teenage today are using it a lot.
Yeah.
It is increasing with teenage today, and it's quite changing us, isn't it? From
like the 90s and stuff.
It's changing. Our life is changing, literally.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Isn't
definitely
it?
Like, because of like the media and everything, like the youth today are definitely becoming like a lot more like sexualized and everything. Like, social media is basically like kind of, I think it's okay to use it as long as you know your boundaries.
There's a borderline again here in this thing. There's a borderline, like, if you use it too much.
Yeah. There's, like,
obviously, excessive use is never good.
Yeah. I think you can, there are like some aspects of it that will kind of, you know, make like better you, that could educate you. Yeah, but then you need to know your boundaries and how to kind of like use it and still remain like respectful, because like a lot of girls nowadays
and boys as well,
they're kind of using social media to
talk to each other
negative ways, like, you know, they're sending like
bad pictures themselves,
nudes to each other, they're sending
They're using it in a very extremely bad way, and
it's kind of like a way of like interaction, because a lot of girls, they don't, like you, for example, you don't go to a mixed school, do you?
No.
So
she goes to
like
all girls school.
Yeah, but then we're kind of lucky because she didn't turn out as bad. But
here we go.
As bad.
But like a lot of the girls who do go to like girls schools, we know, they're kind of like a lot worse than the girls who do go to like a mixed school. Because they kind of use social media to...
In a negative way.
Yeah, and they take advantage of social media to interact with the opposite gender. And
they and have boyfriends and stuff,
and
isn't it?
And
so
when
like
they do it, it kind of goes to an extreme, which is quite...
They think, if you talk to your... they think, because talking to... like having boyfriends and stuff is haram, isn't it?
Yeah.
Isn't it? And like social media randomly makes it okay.
Yeah.
It doesn't make it okay. It's still haram, isn't it?
Yeah. They think because they're not... physically, you know, interacting with each other, it's okay. But then it's like, it's your intentions that count, because Allah knows everything. He sees everything, he knows everything, he hears everything. So he knows what your intentions are. If you say, oh, if I'm not physically, you know, interacting with them or touching them, or that, it doesn't count. But it does count, because your intentions are to, you know, like romantically be in a relationship with that person,
which is haram. It's not allowed.
Like premarital relationships are not allowed in Islam, is it?
No,
it's not allowed.
I think that's like a way social media can kind of like, they have like a negative impact on the youth of this generation. And there's another thing, like teenagers get so kind of like addicted.
They spend like hours upon hours on their phone, checking their news, new messages,
and it's like really bad, because obviously
it's not only distracting you from your
education,
studies, but it's distracting you from Allah.
Yeah.
It is getting you away from Allah, isn't it? Yeah.
Because like obviously...
you could be investing that time that you're putting into social media, which really isn't going to benefit your... Like, it's not really that beneficial to your life. You could be investing it into something that's so much more important. Like
praying.
You can do so reading much books. With that.
Even, like, watch a documentary. Sit at home, go on YouTube, watch a documentary. YouTube is a form of social media. So, yeah, you can use social media.
You can use it in a good way. You can use it in the bad ways.
Yeah.
It's a very controversial subject. And people think it's good. Some people think it's bad. Some people think it's destroying your childhood. Because remember, guys, you only have one childhood. And if you...
Spend your whole childhood
on social media, as lots of little kids these days have phones and stuff. We're not little, but like 10, 11.
A lot of little kids. Like, I know my neighbour, she's like literally like 7 years old. Her birthday present, I think, was a phone.
Was like an iPhone. Is it?
Yeah, it was like an iPhone 4 or something.
That's literally going to destroy her childhood, isn't it?
What do they need it for?
Exactly. You don't need a phone. You don't need a phone when you're in secondary school, to be honest. Like,
you do.
Unless it's for like calling.
Communicate with your parents.
Like, but
I'm like, I'm very, very, very like kind of. I have like a kind of like a very neutral opinion to social media, because I think it is okay for us to use it, because obviously I'm on social media, so I'm not going to be hypocritical about that. But there is a limit. There's like, you can't.
A borderline, yeah, and you can't cross that. Do not use something excessively, like just anything excessively. It's not good. Like, if you study excessively, that's not good. If you do something that's too much,
middle
of it,
way, basically.
Exactly, the middle, always in the middle, isn't it? So,
do it to the point where it's, you know, okay and it's good for you, right? And there's kind of like a lot of things to do with safety as well on social media.
Safety,
I'm sure everyone's heard about.
Everyone's heard of it. There's always posters about internet safety,
e-safety,
and all of that stuff, isn't there?
Basically, I think we shouldn't talk about it because we've had experiences, haven't we? Like not necessarily experiences, but we kind of know. Like, we know people that
happen, you know,
everyone's in the show
cyberbullying.
Like, cyberbullying, catfishing,
all of these little people, fake accounts,
like, especially on Facebook, like girls, not even girls, just like teenagers, they're adding like people that they've never met before, like they're just like friends with hundreds of girls and everything, and like hundreds of other people who they don't know, and like you never know, because they might be like a fake person.
You cannot do that.
It's not that. It's like, it's very dangerous as well, because you've never met that person before. You don't know who they are. They could be anyone behind the screen, you know. Like,
there are so many stories and news reports about girls like
catfishing,
not getting raped and stuff.
Oh, gosh, yes.
Because of Facebook.
So what happens is like. Older man, like say a man who's like 50 or 60 or something, they use pictures of like young boys, young girls, and they kind of use it to like allure children, and it's called paedophilia, right? Allure children too, and that's why social media can be very, very dangerous, because you never know who it is that you're talking to, you never know, and also the pictures. Hijabis are taking their hijabs off. Wearing very
Hannah Montana.
No, because in real life, right, they're like all covered up and just, you know, proper modest.
Randomly,
but in pictures, they're just like wearing, like, proper revealing
it
their
makes
hair
right.
out, like,
right.
you know. And they think that it's all right because, you know, it's on
saying,
social
this
media.
This is saying, this is not Hannah Montana. You can't have the best of both worlds. Because at the end of the day, like I said, Allah is seeing everything. He knows everything. He knows your intentions. So if, like, what is the point of wearing hijab if you're wearing hijab and showing, like, covering yourself just to show to your parents, oh yeah, I'm like, because I know a lot of girls, they like wear hijab in front of their parents. As soon as they're out of the house, they take everything off, they wear like tight clothes, short clothes underneath, and they kind of go out revealingly.
It's so bad. It's not even just that's not just
like, you're
not here to judge anyone though, isn't it? We're not here
but
to judge,
obviously,
we're
like,
here to like guide you to the right path,
because it's not. Like, because the thing is, so basically, like I was saying, so they kind of wear revealing clothes underneath and they take it off, and it's kind of really bad, because Allah knows everything you're doing, and it's like, it's your intentions that's bad. Like, if your intentions are bad, Allah's going to know that your intentions are bad, and that's what's most important, rather than...
But the problem is, other people... judging them and stuff, like, we can't judge them, like,
we're definitely not judging them, we're just trying to take them on the right path, advise you, because your parents
we're not here to judge
they're telling you to wear a hijab because obviously they know what's best for you. They know what's, you know.
Exactly.
They obviously want you to go to heaven.
There's no point of hiding anything from your parents. Yeah. If you're doing anything bad at all, there's no point of hiding it, literally. And another point I was going to say is that because of social media and the excessive amount a lot of teenagers are using it today, the childhood, obviously, going back to children and stuff, it's ruining their childhood. Like, going out, like, all the beautiful things in life.
I think people, like misuse social media, and especially, like, obviously, because, like, they're young, they're kind of naive about, like, the bigger, like, they don't see the bigger picture of social media, so they think, like, you know, like, they can do whatever they want on it, but it's, like, certain things are actually, like, really, like, dangerous about social media, because obviously they can misuse it, as in they, like, catfishing, yeah, okay, like, all
but,
that
but
stuff.
Okay, but just remember the point that children are going to go away from the childhood and start going on the phones and stuff, and then they can't build forts. Like, the beautiful things you can do, like, go swimming, go park.
Yeah, because I'm, like, if they're, because obviously, like, they go on social media so much to the point where, like, they're outside,
it's like,
social life is kind of just, like, gone down the hill. Like, when we were younger, we used to, like, go out, like, you know, we used to just go park every day, we used to just sit out every single day. But then when I see, like, my cousins or, like, my little nieces, they're just, like, constantly on their, like, phones,
or
like,
their phone.
And it's just so bad because obviously they're young, they need the childhood, like,
you need that childhood. You need to go outside and build forts, experience life.
A lot of things to do with social media is it's just like you're kind of getting happy. Like Zahin said, you're getting taken away from your childhood, and it's causing. It's like the media is kind of influencing you to do bad things as well, because on social media you see these other girls who are like very, very beautiful, but they kind of like obviously, unmodest, kind of, they show their skin. Like, maybe, like, from people from different cultures, like, maybe, like, if they're British or Christians.
And not even Asians as well. Even Asians as well,
sometimes.
Yeah, but
if it's, like, some people...
A lot of Asians.
No, and a lot of religions is acceptable. Like, it's okay to, you know, wear revealing clothes. And that's fine, it's in their religion, but it's, like, Muslim girls are getting influenced by that, and they're getting...
They think that that's the right thing to do.
Yeah, they think it's okay to do it because everybody else is doing it, and... I think the media is kind of influencing and kind of just like manipulating the children of today's society. It's kind of, they're kind of drifting away from their culture, they're drifting away from their roots, from their parents, and like the peer pressure is causing them to do a lot of negative.
And it's like a whole new world, isn't it?
Yeah.
There's like a lot of things as well, like cyberbullying.
It's like, you're not in this world when you're using it. It's like, I don't know, it's like you're talking like, it's like real life and social media. It's like two different things, literally. Like, and if you're in that social media world all the time, then you forget what's in real life, isn't it? You
like
forget
reality.
Reality, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, you move on. Because obviously, like, social media is, like, really... Like, there's negative parts of it, as in, like, you know, like, cyberbullying and all that kind of, like... All that kind
of
stuff.
A lot of suicides are happening because of cyberbullying.
Oh, yeah,
it's so sad.
I think, I think that's why it's best if young people kind of stay clear of social media. Like, we only use social media to interact with our friends from school, to be honest. That's, like, the most...
And meet new people sometimes,
yeah,
isn't
that's
it?
The most smart thing to do. And sometimes in social media, you send... There's peer pressure. People, girls and boys in relationships, they send...
Bad pictures.
Pictures to each other, which are not very, you know, kind of family friendly. Like, so things that you wouldn't show your parents, your siblings, you know. And
then they get
exposed.
They get exposed.
When they break up or when the relationship ends, or if they get into an argument, what they do is they post a picture on the internet.
Because obviously,
and
like, whatever.
And obviously, when you put something on the internet,
it stays there.
It stays there. Because you don't know who screenshotted it. You don't know who saved it.
And remember, guys.
The cyber footprint. So, like, even if you delete it and remove it off of
it's still gonna be out there.
You can recover it, you know. It's still gonna be on.
So remember, guys, think before you post anything or you send anything to anyone.
Because obviously, like, a lot of jobs these days as well, like, they got, before, like, the job employers, before they employ someone, they kind of, like, go on internet and like search like what they've like posted or like when they're younger what they've done. And like obviously if that it's like you used to like post really like bad pictures and you know
controversial
pictures up on there, they're not gonna want to, you know, employ you, yeah.
Because obviously, and basically what the employer would do, they would just like they would search your name up to see what comes up, just to do a bit of
background
research.
Check.
Yeah, background research about you to see if it's okay for them to hire you. But then obviously if it's not okay, they're kind of gonna be like, you know, they're if they see like all of these kind of iffy things.
Yeah, they're gonna think negatively of you. So you have to like really, really be careful what you post online, and you know, because no matter like what, like if you delete it, you might think, oh, it's, you know, it's gone, but it's still gonna be out there somewhere in the internet. Like it's never gonna just disappear. Yeah.
Think before you send something. That's all I'm gonna say. And there's a lot to talk about. Literally.
So obviously like social media is like a big.
Social media is like relevant.
It's a good thing.
Everybody's life nowadays.
Yeah. Everybody's life. Because and like, you know, you never know.
Computers, tablets, and like, I think it's just like, you just need to know your boundaries. You need to. Basically, I think the most important thing in Islam is like modesty. So you just need to know your boundaries. Kind of need to know how to keep in line and kind of like I don't know how to explain it now. But basically, as long as you follow like the rules of modesty and like know how to remain modest.
Yeah, yeah. That's like. Because obviously, like because you're
okay
Muslim.
To use social media as long as you're modest.
Yeah, as long as you
a good Muslim.
You do stuff that, you know, obviously a good Muslim will do, like, not search up inappropriate things and, you know.
There's a lot to talk about, literally. It's literally everything. It's and you never know, in the future, we might have, like, flying cars and anything, literally. And technology is really increasing, isn't
it? Yeah, it's, like, rapidly increasing. Like, when I was...
Very fast. Like,
a few years ago...
Literally a few years ago,
like,
there was nothing.
You know, the internet was only invented in 2000. Like there was no internet.
Can you believe it? And Mac computers
and
were
now
all literally
new.
So like cell phones were like blocks. There was no internet on cell phones.
And that
like,
wasn't a long time ago, to be honest.
I think people back then they were still okay. They weren't struggling, you know.
Yeah, because you always hear, who agrees with me? We always hear your parents saying, "Oh, we never had mobile phones in our age."
Oh my
and
gosh!
Stuff.
Yeah.
Literally, oh my god.
It's like, oh, when we were younger,
we never had colour TV.
No, the thing is, the generation has changed, and now
a lot.
I think having a mobile phone with you is quite important to kind of communicate with your parents, communicate with people around you, because the world is becoming like more and more unsafe.
Dangerous.
And there are a lot more like dangerous people out and about, so
yeah,
you just need to like you need to have a mobile phone to contact the police, to contact your parents
if anything does happen, which hopefully
to be honest
not.
For entertainment, because
movies,
well, when you get bored and just you know watch movies, like I watch
like social media isn't always bad. Literally go on YouTube, type like documentaries about
and you gain knowledge, isn't it? That's what they do. That's what Chimera Nabila does.
Yeah, we watch documentaries and our
and they time. Literally are so knowledgeable because of that. Literally they know everything.
No.
They are very clever.
Mashallah.
No, I'm not getting you too gassed. just saying the honest truth, isn't it? Yeah, so... back to our topic, cyberbullying.
Not cyberbullying, social media interaction.
Yeah, but within
but
that
within, yeah, the cyberbullying.
That is very...
Oh my gosh, yeah, like cyberbullying's huge in this area because obviously... Like
people
our age,
and then there are people that hate each other.
They're very judgmental.
Yeah. People our age are so judgmental and
they're offended.
Yeah,
they
like they put
like look for things like they look for like fights and stuff to entertain themselves. I think it's kind of like.
So yes, and they think like they should use social media to do that, as in like. Because, you know, like, people, like, anonymously, like, say rude stuff about other people online, like, ask if... in my school, there's this huge thing that happened where, like, people, like, random anonymous people were saying really rude stuff about others on
Ask a Fem.
Yeah. And, yeah, it got so huge, and then people ended up... They were, like, crying in school, this and that, and then they told the teacher, and then, the police and everything were involved. That's how big it got. And it's just, like, it just shows how... Like, how serious it actually is, because
on that topic, you said anonymous, something about that, like, people take advantage of the fact that they're anonymous on the internet, because they will say things that they would never have the guts to say to someone else.
Fake accounts.
Not just fake accounts, just like
they will use their
anonymity to basically say very, 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 like, rude things, kind of like death threats, just like stuff that you'd never say to someone face
in person,
to face, yeah, in person. And
they think it's the internet, it's alright. Yeah. Internet, nothing will happen to me. I won't get caught. They won't find it's me and stuff. And that's why they have the guts to do that, to do on the internet. Because the internet, you're not face to face. Like, they're not actually there.
Yeah.
So that's why people are tempted to do this kind of things.
Yeah.
So to summarize, the advantages of social media interaction is gaining a knowledge, like education and stuff.
And even like
literally, you can have a school on the computer, literally, like the amount of websites there are.
Yeah.
And like math, science, English, all subjects are literally on the internet. You can gain so much knowledge. Like, because in books and stuff, you have to like read it and then search it up, and that's very long, isn't it?
But
a word you don't understand. But on the internet, it's like literally instantly like that. So that's one advantage. Another advantage is that you're able to interact with your cousins and stuff back home in Bangladesh. You're able to talk to anyone.
Which is like really good. Cause
it's good, and there's a downside of it as well.
Because obviously,
it's a good thing as well, because you're like
able to talk to other people you're not in person with.
Yeah, basically. You're socializing. And another advantage is that
basically, you can interact with your friend, you can interact with your family, you can communicate.
It helps you out of dangers as well, as it gets you in it. It does help you out of, like, dangers. Like, you can quickly call 911 or if there's literally any emergency situation you are in.
Search up for advice. You know Yahoo Answers?
I love that so much.
So, like, you don't know what to do.
You can search up anything and they will give you advice. They'll tell you, like, other people your age, people who've understood the situation, they will
advice on anything, literally anything.
Yeah, literally. So
from education to Islam to
social media definitely has ups and its downs, but
ups
I think
downs,
I do think like the positives kind of trump the negatives, but
the negatives are very
The negatives are very, includes, very negative.
It includes death and stuff, isn't it?
So I think you just need to know how to keep safe, know how to remain within like the Islamic modesty kind of, you know, boundaries.
And don't get too addicted to it. Please do not get addicted to it.
Excessively.
Because it's just a phone, it's just a tablet, just a computer, it's nothing to be honest. It's a device, it's not your life. So people always say constantly, I can't live without my phone. Always my phone. Stuff like that. Oh, my life's gone now.
Literally, I think real life interactions, like I'm talking to you face to face, we can actually communicate.
I can see your face expression.
Exactly.
Like, not just emojis. Emojis.
So I think real life kind of like physical interactions is so much better than
just typing
social media interactions. So I think it's better if you go out, enjoy kind of like the world, enjoy what's out there instead of staying on your phone, trapped on your phone. Like, go out, exercise, get some fresh air.
Talk to people,
socialise.
Go to the park with your siblings, your friends, play football, you know, whatever. Girls can play
be active,
exercise. Instead of being on your
bed, underneath your blanket,
24/7
during the holiday, I did
that
yesterday.
On your phone,
I was on
the whole day yesterday.
I was on the phone the entire day yesterday.
Mashallah.
So she sounds like such
a great example.
Eating food and sleeping. That's literally
no exercise.
So bad.
Great
See?
Example.
And then like in the night time, I had a headache because it's just too much, like staying on it for that long.
Yeah, you do get
way too much.
But don't you know that scientists are saying that if you like on your screen, in the night time, if you keep looking at your screen,
it strains your eyes.
It's very, very bad for your eyes.
Yeah.
For some reason.
It's damaging.
Damaging.
I think you just need to know your boundaries, be respectful, and just, you know, you are allowed to use social media. I think basically ask your parents. if before you use social media, people laugh, people like doing
because they lie about their age. So unfortunately, because obviously, like, on Facebook, there's like an age limit, like, you have to be over 13, I think. Yeah. But and then some people lie about their age, going like, yeah, I'm 16, 17, whatever. That's what go on social media. Yeah. Like, people in year six, year five, they're on like Facebook and all these stuff.
You're
I'm
on
just
on
like.
Facebook when you're in year six?
Yeah, but then obviously, because I only had like my school. Yeah, but I was only talking to like my school friends on there, but yeah, like, people proper young, they're starting to use Facebook, but then they're kind of obviously they're young, they don't know what they're doing on there, so they take advantage of social media and they do wrong stuff on there. And I think it's like for parents as well, like they need to know like get what involved. The children are doing online and like put restrictions on stuff. Yeah,
that's it. That's what I think parents should put restrictions and just pray. Read your books, study, but then you can go on social media.
Fancy, man. Yeah. But that should be a small portion of
a
your
small
life,
portion you know? Of your time, how you spend your time.
Yeah.
All right. And so unfortunately, we've only got a little bit time left. So it was a very very fun topic. I agree. I really like the social media interaction. It's got a lot of things aspects to it, isn't it? It's got negatives, positives. We just need to make sure that we don't cross the borderline. That's it, really, isn't it? It's not that much. Just don't cross the borderline. Don't cross the borderline in anything. Just always remain modest and remain truthful and faithful to religion and to Allah.
And just be positive, you know? Optimistic.
Don't be pessimistic.
So,
that's it, really. Yeah. Thank you so much for watching.
And we're really excited to be here.
Jazakallah for all the audience watching Out of Focus. Thank you, Nabila, for coming to our show. Thank you, Shamila, for contributing to our topic.
Yeah, today was really fun. Yeah, like, I enjoyed talking about this topic.
Onik onik dhonnobad dichi.
No English.
For your time to discuss with us and to listen to our views on social media interaction. Thank you, Jazakallah. I hope you keep note of what all the things we have said about social media. Just don't do anything excessively. Just remember that, okay? Thanks very much. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.